YouTube, what it is? It's your boy Gannon, and I'm right back at you with another video. Matter of fact, welcome and thank you if you are part of the Sim Standard and you clicked on this video and now you're listening to this video when I'm giving my top five enhancements that they need to do for NBA 2K13. And it's the same deal here. If you have different or the same ideas, please put them in the comments. Like I said before, I'm going to put this on the NBA 2K12 forums, and I'm going to tweet these videos to Ronnie2K on Twitter or whatever. So if you have ideas, please put them in the comments. This is a community. I'm doing this for the community, about the community, whatever. So let's get into this. Number five, better and deeper in-game tutorials and online tutorials. Now, what I mean by the in-game tutorials and offline tutorials, right? It's good that they gave us tutorials on how to do dribble moves and different jump shots and everything, but what if somebody doesn't know how to set those jump shots up? They don't exactly understand when to drive the ball or what layups to do in which situation. That's what I mean by offline tutorials. We need way better and deeper tutorials. We need more of something needs to tell us, because you know the instruction booklet don't have much in it. So it has to, 2K has to do a much better job with in-game tutorials teaching people of, you know, the actual ins and outs of basketball, you know, stuff like what hedging means and, you know, all these type of things, because it's a lot of people who just don't understand basketball. And that was one of the main frustrations of NBA 2K12, because a lot of people feel as though they should do what they want to do, and that's all fine. You can still, trust me when I tell you, you can still do exactly what you want to do in this game, playing a straight up game. You just have to learn how to set it up. So that's one thing that they just didn't really do a good job of. Now, online tutorials, check this out. The color commentator, both of the color commentating actually, they need to do a better job of telling us, you know, if we took a bad shot, if we rushed a shot, if we forced a shot. They need to do that more on a consistent basis. That's number one. That's an easy thing that they could do. Another thing they could do is actually introduce coach advice or something like that. When you call a timeout, or maybe the coach could have some kind of talk to the player saying, you know, this is online games, okay? Or when you're playing a game, they could tell you, hey, you know, we're missing a lot of jump shots, you know, take better quality shots. Something. They have to do something while you're playing the game to let you know if you're playing the wrong or right way. Something. Give us a grade. Something. Okay. Another thing which would be great for online games would be, give me the option so that I could put up my shot quality and my release quality, just like they have in practice. Now, I'm not saying they should tell me where my hot spots are and everything like that. No. What it should be is exactly what it is in practice. If I'm playing a game online, the lag could get to me. You know, like, say if you're shooting a free throw, everybody knows this, you're shooting a free throw online, you release it earlier than when you're actually supposed to, or you release it at that time and it says late or too early or whatever the case is. That's the lag. So if I'm taking jump shots, you think that lag goes anywhere? No, it's still there. So there's no clear fire way knowing, you know, if you release something too late or too early. Now, as the game itself is telling you, quality is good, but your release is too late or too early, you know. And then when you're giving me a quality, is let me know, hey, I rushed a shot. I took a shot with good defense on me, and that's why I missed it. People will really appreciate that in the game, and a lot more people wouldn't resort to picking cheap ass teams to play the game. Okay, enough said about that. That's a big number five, right? Number four, much better and deeper online communities. I've said this already, but I didn't give this example. This is my number four. It's not my number one. A lot of people really want that. Me, this is my list. This is what I do. Okay, so this is my number four. Deeper online communities must be in the game. Now, I play a lot of Soul Calibur, right? The Global Coliseum, mwah, I love that feature in the game. You can see somebody's record. Say you go to the Global Coliseum, right? You could click on somebody, you could see their record, you could challenge them to a game, you can see their online connection. Actually, you can't see their record, but that should be something that should be in 2K13. You can see their online connection, you can see their ranking at least, you know, because I think they go A, B, C, D, E, F, or something like that, maybe not F, but, you know, A being the highest, E being somebody who just started out. You can at least see that. You can see where they are if they did their regional icon or whatever. And then on top of that, then you could get into a pool where it's random players. And on top of that, the Global Coliseum, you have one in New York, San Francisco, California, Chicago, whatever you have, you know. And since I'm in New Jersey, I'm gonna go to the New York. Most people in that era will go to New York, I would think. So that right off the bat is gonna help out with the connection. That's what they need to do for online ranked games and online unranked games, whatever, all that type of stuff. That needs to be in the game. Okay, my number three is kind of consistent. Passing needs to be way better. I'm not so much barking on the passing packages, even though that'd be awesome and great. And what I mean by passing packages is actual animations, signature animations for their passing. Okay, I want more control with my passing. Okay, I want to throw a bounce pass, I want to throw a lob pass, I want to throw a bullet pass, stuff like that. That's what I truly, truly want. Okay, making this way down this list real quick, right? I know that number five was pretty long, but I had to really explain that. And I think that would be a really great idea with the online tutorials. But moving on, more player control. I've said this already, but this is my number two. More player control. I hate when I'm trying to drive the lane and it's some unseen force keeping me from driving the lane, or I have a wide open lane and I'm actually driving and I'm trying to do a layup and he stops to do a jump shot and misses, of course. Why is that? Now, stuff like that, oh, that needs to be fixed. Okay, that's what I mean by more player control. And maybe try to make the dribble moves a little easier to do if you can, you know. Also, sometimes when I feel like I'm trying to do a crossover or something like that, I do a round the back spin move dribble. Like the player controls are not as tight as what I would want them to be. They need to fix that as well. So that's number two. More player control. I don't need to go much in depth at it because I already made a video about it, right? If you guys looked at the Sim Standard video. Matter of fact, I'll have a link in the description or on the video itself so that my subscribers could look at that as well. So, number one, my biggest problem with NBA 2K12 was the over-governing AI in competitive gaming. Man, I hate that. And also, I also hate the fact that OKC, a team like OKC, yeah, they have one of the top NBA records right now. And so does the Miami Heat. But why the hell are they so good? Anybody could pick them up basically and start beating people. What I mean by that is, of course, if somebody don't know that never played a basketball game, you know, of course they're going to lose to somebody who's skilled. But I'm saying somebody who's pretty skilled would go up against somebody who's really, really skilled with a worse team. The person who's just average skill with the Miami Heat would play somebody who's very skilled with, I don't know, let's say the Pistons or the Rockets or somebody like that. They would have an extremely hard time beating somebody with the Heat who is actually somewhat skilled. You know, I think they need to balance out the teams a little bit more. Yes, I understand that it's a simulated game, but it doesn't need to be so crazy that anybody can pick up the Heat, run around with LeBron James all damn day, just swiping, pressing the steal button and getting steals, and then free alley-oops and dunks, and James Harden is almost impossible to stop. Excuse me. That's what I mean. Also, you know, like I said, with the over-governing AI in competitive gameplay, they need to stop that. Keep the momentum in the game, but you know, so much of the overgoverning AI needs to go away, especially when I'm passing the ball and it goes right to the defense. Or, you know, one time this happened to me. I don't have any footage of this, and I was just dribbling down the court. And, you know, I always play with the Knicks. So I had the ball in Lynn's hands, and what's his name? Landry Fields is on the right side of me, and he cuts over to the left side to get to the left side of the court, and he knocks the ball out of my hands into LeBron James's hand. Come on, man. Something like that needs to never, ever happen in the game. And I know that was that overbearing AI just to make my day bad because I'm playing with the Knicks and they have the Heat and they're supposed to lose to the Heat in real life. You know, so stuff like that needs to be taken out of the game. And I'm leaving you guys out with that. Yo, check out this Sim Standard video that I did. It's a different list, and I have different ideas and things that I see which is wrong. So check that out. And I think this will just about do it. I got more videos. I got a little bit more Call of Duty videos. I got more episodic videos, that those mission videos. Matter of fact, check out that video as well. I'm gonna put this up too. And I guess that's it. And we out of here.